Good evening, friends. Mr. Vinod Maske and Mr. Sumit Junjunwala, the coordinator for the joint workshop. Seniors in the friends and fellow participants. At the outset, I would like to thank all the six associations for giving me an opportunity to share my views on today's topic, that is provisions of e-way bill, interception and procedure itself. Friends, in my presentation, I have raised almost 40 issues and also given the answer. I want this session to be interactive as far as possible. You can try to give the answer, even though it is wrong, doesn't matter. We all are learners, including myself, although I am standing on other side, because law itself is a learning process. So friends, I will request everybody to try and give the answer. Now coming to subject proper. Friends, e-way bill, before going to that, see, those who are doing practice since last so many years, they must be knowing this e-way bill is not a new concept except Maharashtra. In earlier also, other than Maharashtra, in so many states there was the same provision. We would call it as a way bill. In that, the system was, suppose a dealer is in Andhra, he wants to purchase the goods from say Maharashtra, then he used to go to the department, take the way bill in the name of the dealer supplier, and then he used to send that way bill to the vendor, and vendor has to send goods along with this way bill to the buyer, so that there would not be any problem at check post, etc. So I would say this is not a new concept, but Maharashtra people, we are not aware, because e-way bill first time it was introduced, so we might be facing so many difficulties. But now almost more than 1 year have been passed, so I think everybody is used to that. So first, let us understand what is the provisions of e-way bill. E-way bill is an electronic movement of goods which can be generated on GSTPAM portal if your value of goods exceeding rupees 50,000. So whenever you send, any dealer is sending the goods more than rupees 50,000, they are supposed to prepare e-way bill. For Maharashtra, the limit is rupees 1 lakh. But if you sell to out of Maharashtra interstate, the limit would be 50,000. This differentiation you have to keep it in your mind. Don't be under impression ke 1 lakh sab jagah. 1 lakh is only for interstate transaction and 50,000 is for interstate. And if you are selling taxable as well as exempted category of goods, then for considering the value of this limit, you should exclude non-taxable and exempted supplies. As we know, in Maharashtra, it was implemented from 25th May 2018. Portal had been activated from 1st of February 2018, that is www.ewaybillgst.gov.in. Now, what are the objectives for bringing this e-way bill procedure? Single e-way bill for movement of goods throughout the country. So, every time we did not generate e-way bill to prevent the evasion of the tax, that is the main motto. This hawala transaction, all that thing, to curb that transaction, this has been introduced. Hassle-free movement of goods across India, but practically we know how much it is hassle-free in real sense. Taking the movement of goods with e-way bill number, and for proper officer it would be easier to verify because everything is available on portal, so it would be easier for them. What are the benefits? As I already said earlier, the dealer used to go to the department and collect way bill. Now there is no need to go to the department. Dealer on their own, he can generate on their computer system e-way bill. average waiting time at mobile score reduces drastically because now everything is available on online. Self-policing by trader. It means suppose vendor has uploaded EVA bill in the name of buyer. So name of the buyer would also reflect. So department will get the data who is the buyer. So there is less chance of doing any manipulation or changing the bill. Generation of GSTR 1 return. See, this utility has just recently started. So whenever EVA bill has been generated, then it can be directly picked up from that EVA bill portal to GSTR 1. You need not again and again feed the same detail because it is available in EVA bill. Now this utility has been started. And one more thing over here, even though you just import that data of EVA bill in GSTR 1, you can still modify that. That is good thing. Otherwise, it would have created a lot of problems. But you can modify that data. If you think this is not correct data, you can modify that data. In this EVA bill portal, they have also given some beneficial, like suppose big corporates are there, and every time they did not feed the data like code, then transporter ID, etc. So at one time only they can feed in master, they can create a master. They can even given the power to their subordinates. That also they can restrict. Okay, only one particular employee has got power to restrict to a particular work only. Beyond that he cannot do. So this facility, even bulk generation is also possible. In corporate, there are so many EVA bills has to be generated. So in bulk generation is also possible. And even the management can restrict the sub user also. Suppose it may happen that certain power has been given to a ex employee. Tomorrow he leaves. Then management can restrict that power. The management can cancel. That option is also available in EVA bill. When should an EVA bill be generated? Every registered person who causes movement of goods of consignment value exceeding ₹50,000 in relation to a supply for reasons other than supply or due to inward supply from unregistered person, sale before commence, means suppose for supply definitely, other than supply like branch transfer, job work, etc., then also it is required. And dealer who is purchasing goods from unregistered dealer, then registered dealer has to generate the EVA bill in form number EWB01. For certain category, they have made it compulsory EVA bill irrespective of the monetary limit of 50,000. For job work, suppose any principal is sending goods to job worker for processing and in turn job work is returning, then irrespective of the value of goods, EVA bill needs to be generated. Similarly, handicraft goods. See, in GST, handicraft good is exempted. But I don't know what is the reason behind that. They have made it compulsory to generate EVA bill in case of handicraft goods, irrespective of the value of goods. Here also, there is no cap of 50,000. Whether an EVA bill is to be issued even when there is no supply? Yes. Even though there is no supply, EVA bill has to be generated, like job work is there, SKD or CKD means if you are supplying any goods in semi knockdown condition or completely knocked down condition, still EVA bill is required. You are supplying the goods, but you don't know to whom you have to send, recipient not known, not known, then also it is required. Supply of liquid gas where quantity is not known, supply returns like sales return, then also EVA bill is exhibition, you are taking the goods for taking part in exhibition or fair and you are taking back that goods, still both the time EVA bill needs to be generated. For own use, suppose my head office is over here, factory is in Gujarat, I am transferring certain item for doing process or for any work to my head of branch or factory, then also EVA bill needs to be generated. And supply on approval, that is goods sent on approval, still EVA bill is required. What is supply? As we know, section 7 defines what is supply, but in general, supply may be supplied for a consideration in the course of business, supplies made for consideration which may not be in the course of business, supplies without consideration. Basically, supply means sale, transfer, barter, exchange, etc.
What about gifts?
Gift means you are giving gift to whom? Is but still it's a part of business. Still it would be required.
Buyer address is not there, as you said, it is unknown.
But unknown. When you are sending goods to somebody, then you must be knowing to whom you are sending.
You said that buyer is unknown.
The e-way bill is must. In that case also e-way bill is must. See, what example I had given, it was in the case of URD dealer. URD dealer sending the goods to somebody who is not knowing who is the ultimate receiver. In that case also the e-way bill needs to be generated by URD. The opposite person is suppose known, and if it is RD, then RD has to generate. It is like, see, in e-way bill hardly any transactions are there where e-way bill may not be required. Almost in all the situation e-way bill has to be generated. No, but when you send, you have to generate e-way bill. At the time of sending, you have to generate e-way bill, no? If you're not send, there is no question. Suppose the goods are kept in your factory and destroyed, so there is no need. But if you send in transit, it was destroyed. So while sending, e-way bill needs to be generated. In the following case, it is not necessary to generate e-way bill. Suppose goods transported through non-motorized vehicle, समझो आप साइकिल में भेजे, हथगाड़ी में, like this, e-way bill is not required. So I think a dealer may plan to send the goods.
रिक्शा,
वो तो व्हीकल आ गया. See. Actually speaking, it is not required, but if it is a big value, and I would suggest in that case, because hand carry means क्या होता है, आप समझो, ये दुकान से बाजू की दुकान में जाते हैं तो ठीक है, but suppose take a case, I have taken this example, suppose my customers, I am in say Majgaon, my customer is in Ghatkopar, I am using cab or I am using train or bus, and in that case it would be required. Like this.
Delivery challan.
Huh? No, that depend upon transaction. Delivery challan. No, if it is not for supply, then delivery challan would be okay. But if it is a supply, then delivery challan would not helpful to you. Then invoice has to be there, like this. My request is, first let me finish my request to all of you. Let me finish my presentation. I have tried to cover almost all practical issues whatever we face in our day-to-day practice, and still if anything left, you can ask me. I'll sort out that, don't worry about that. Where the goods are being transported in custom, from the samjho custom port to custom station, then from one custom station to another custom station, then also e-way bill is not required. Goods are exempted other than DOL CAC. Then the goods which you are carrying or which you are sending, which are covered in Schedule 3. If you are, it is covered Schedule 3, we know that it is neither supply of goods nor supply of service. Then also no e-way bill would be required. Then transit cargo transported to or from Nepal or Bhutan. Then movement of goods caused by Defense Ministry. Then empty cargo. Sometimes it may happen, you send empty cargo to say another state for bringing certain goods. Then also e-way bill is not required. Then suppose you are sending your goods for weighing, weigh bridge. And if the distance from your place of business to the weigh bridge, if it is up to 20 kilometers, then also e-way bill would not be required within the state. Then goods transported by rail and consignor is railway itself, then also e-way bill would not be required. Then if goods are specifically exempt by a particular state or union territory, then also EWA bill is not required. An empty cylinder for packing liquefied petroleum waste. And lastly, they have described certain items, annexure they have given. If that item, if your item is falling under that annexure, then also EWA bill need not be generated. What are that item? LPG for supply of household and non-domestic exempted category, kerosene oil sold under PDS, public distribution system, postal baggage, like post they carry the courier and everything, parcel, etc. They need not generate EWA bill. Then natural or cultural pearls, diamond or precious stone, then jewelry, gold jewelry, silver jewelry, currency, used personal and household effect. Used personal and household effect is also being exempted, and coral, unwork and work coral. So in all, there are four key players in EWA bill. Who are that? Then supplier, recipient, transporter and department, correct? So what is the power of supplier? Supplier can register and generate EWA bill, and he has also power to reject the EWA bill. Suppose EWA bill has been generated by the buyer, not the seller, then also seller has got right to reject that. Similarly, recipient has the power to register and generate EWA bill, and also power to reject the bill. Transporter, he can generate the EWA bill. He can also fill part A if the vendor is not filled, and he can also fill part B. He can also assign a particular EWA bill to another transporter. And departmental officer, department shall verify EWA bill through portal. Who can generate EWA bill? See, EWA bill can be generated by a registered person, that is seller or buyer. They have to fill part A in form GST EWB 1 on the common portal, and they have to give the detail of transporter in part B. Suppose part A has been filled up by the supplier or the recipient, and they also filled the part B in this, then based on that, suppose it has not been filled, assume it has not been filled, then based on the invoice or any other document given to the transporter, transporter can also fill part A as well as part B. Both are possible. It is also provided that if even the value of consignment is less than 50,000, then it has been optional for either recipient or supplier to generate EWA bill. It is not compulsory. If they want, they can generate EWA bill. लेकिन ऐसा तो कोई करेगा नहीं, आ बिल मुझे मार वाला तो कोई करने वाला नहीं है. Who shall generate EWA bill? Suppose if it is for outward supply, value is more than 50,000, by any person, supplier, recipient or transporter, any other outward movement, that is other than supply, then also anybody, supplier, recipient or transporter. Suppose goods are purchased from unregistered dealer and recipient is known, then by registered recipient. But same, if goods are purchased from unregistered dealer and recipient is not known, then limit is zero, and unregistered dealer or the transporter has to generate EWA bill. Here it can't be like this, something URD chhoot jayega. URD ko bhi EWA bill generate karne ka hai if opposite party is not RD. If opposite party is RD, he will generate, otherwise he himself has to generate. If capital goods or input sent by principal to job worker, as I say, no limit, and it should be generated by principal. Handicraft goods also no limit, and it should be generated by registered supplier or transporter. All movement of goods less than 50,000, yes, it is an optional. And if the goods are sending to the transporter within Maharashtra state, from the place of business to the transporter place, if it is within 50 kilometers, then e-way bill has to be generated. Only part B need not be filled. That is optional, means it is allowable. Only part B. It's not like that ke 50 kilometer ke andar hai. Wo bhi, it is only in the case when you are sending the goods to the transporter. It is not otherwise. Mind well. Aisa nahi ki it is not general ki bhai mera ek branch 30 kilometer ke andar hai, maine bhej diya. I have to generate e-way bill. This benefit has been given only between supplier and the transporter when the kilometer is up to 50 kilometers. This is also same EWB1. There is also a possibility when, as you know, transporter carries consignment of various customer. There is also a possibility that, say, there are 100 consignment, and out of that 15 consignment has less than 50,000, correct? But in all, if we'll consider the whole truck value, it would be more than 50,000. So for transporter, it is required to generate e-way bill. He can't be exceptional. He has to generate. But for supplier, if it is less than 50,000, he would not generate e-way bill. There is also an option available. Suppose individual e-way bill must have been generated by the respective consigner. So what transporter has to do in this case, he can feed the detail that individual e-way bill serial number, and he can generate consolidated e-way bill in EWB 02. That transporter can do, correct? So individually one number form has to be filled, and for consolidation e-way bill number 2 EWB 2 needs to be filled. What are the various points that needs to be noted for updating part B of GST EWB 1? In part B, for supplier, he just have to write transporter name or transporter ID. But vehicle number, if it is by road, then transporter has to fill vehicle number. If it is by railway, then railway receipt serial number and date of railway receipt. If it is by air, then serial number and date of air consignment note. And if it is by ship, then serial number and date of bill of lading. This needs to be filled in part B. There are so many cases happen, because I was referring before preparing this lecture, the major problem is part B. So many judgments I have referred for this lecture. Major problem, major interception of goods is because of defect or non-filling of the part B. Major.
So, if part B is not filled by the transporter,
liability would be on supplier. If your transporter is good, he will reimburse fine enough. Otherwise, it's a responsibility of the supplier. I agree, but time responsibility is of the supplier. He cannot escape. Who shall update vehicle details in part B? Transporter or a supplier also, if he has got the detail. But suppose supplier has chosen one particular, say, SAR transport. He has written SAR transport is transporter ID. He has assigned that consignment to the transporter. Then suppose transporter has put the vehicle number. Then supplier don't have any right to change the transporter. Once the vehicle number has been put in part B, then supplier don't have any right to change over the transport. Concept of transport ID, as we know, under GST, transporter needs to be registered. But there are certain transporters who are not registered. if they are having GSTPAM number, no problem at all. But suppose if transporter are not registered, then for them provision has been made that they need to take transporter ID. They will call it as a enrolled transporter, and those who are having GSTPAM number, they are call it as a registered. Because without transporter ID, how any customer will assign the transaction or goods to you for further movement of goods? So for that they need to have a transporter ID. What are the contents of e-way bill? GSTPAM number of consignor, name of the consignor, address from where the goods are to be dispatched, and details of supporting document number and date, GSTPAM of consignee to whom the goods are being sent, name of the consignee, address where the goods are to be sent, details of goods, description, HSN, quantity, UQC, value, details of taxes leviable, total invoice value, transporter detail, name and ID, and approximate distance in kilometer. Part B, what it consists of? Mode of transfer, that is by rail, road, ship or air, vehicle type, lorry hai or any other vehicle is there, vehicle number, transport document number, LR number and date, HSN code. See, this HSN code, if the turnover in the previous year of the supplier is less than 5 crore, then he need to put 2 digit. If it is more than 5 crore, he need to put 4 digit HSN code. Then transport document number like GRN or railway receipt number. Place of delivery, it means you need to type PIN code where you are going to send the goods. Reason for transporter, whether it is for supply or export or import, job work, sales return or for exhibition or fair, etc. That reason you have to choose when you actually prepare e-way bill. Practically, I don't prepare any e-way bill, let me admit. Because clients are doing, if they are having any problem, I help them. Then if it is in the case of import, then bill of entry detail is to be filled. Once you generate e-way bill, then one unique e-way bill number would be generated. And it will be available to the supplier, recipient, as well as transporter on the common portal. See, there is also a possibility that suppose in one particular truck, transporter is carrying the goods. He has written that vehicle number in part B, generated e-way bill. There are also a chance that because of any reason, maybe breakdown or any other reason, he has to change over the conveyance from one vehicle to another. So in that case, again, he need to update part B. It is required. No e-way bill, new e-way bill is not required, but update vehicle number or mode of transport that he need to fill. Multiple consignment, I already explained that there might be a 100 consignment, out of that 10 or 15 is below 50,000, but in all, if it is more than 50,000 total value or total consignment goods consist in the truck, if it is more than 50,000, he has to generate e-way bill. So in that case, he has to fill individual e-way bill number, and one consolidated e-way bill needs to be generated. Suppose e-way bill has been generated, but by whatever reason, goods are not transferred. It is not transported, or the goods which have been returned in the e-way bill, the say in other than that, any other goods have been transported, then in that case, what is the option? Here, there is no option to delete e-way bill. Once you generate e-way bill, there is no option to delete e-way bill, but it can be canceled within 24 hours. That option is available. You can cancel that. Suppose you have not transported the goods, or goods are not similar what has been written in e-way bill, it can be canceled. this transporter, I already said up to 50 kilometers is not required. What documents are to be carried? Tax invoice or bill of supply or delivery challan, and a copy of e-way bill or e-way bill number, either physically or mapped to a RFID, radio frequency identification device. See, this RFID as provision is also being implemented in very few state rather. Maharashtra, I think it is not started. So in that, what is the procedure? The government will insist to a particular transporter, to every transporter in a particular state, that they have to fix this RFID device. So that because of this device, government can track where the goods are moving. Suppose I have generated e-way bill from Maharashtra to Gujarat, and this truck is diverting to different route today only. Just while I was coming from my office Ghatkopar, I received one judgment. The same case was there. In that, what was happened? The truck driver has taken the wrong route for 7 kilometers. For 7 kilometers, Madras High Court judgment is there, and it was been trapped. It was been trapped, and then they have caught this driver. They have levied penalty of 19 lakh rupees. They have levied penalty of 19 lakh rupees, and the officer has said the driver was not cooperating. But then ultimately, finally, when it was represented, reason what they have given, that officer was speaking English and Hindi language, something. English and Hindi language, not Hindi, English and one more language officer was speaking. Driver was not able to understand that language because he was Bihari or something, he was knowing only Hindi. So he could not understand, and ultimately, finally, the court drove down this penalty to 5,000 rupees. From 19 lakhs, they reduced to 5,000 rupees. So you know how this plays rather. But this RFID become mandatory, then it would be very difficult for doing any type of adjustment or to moving the truck or any vehicle in different route, because it can be kept. For other than supply, even delivery challan would be enough. No need to raise invoice. Validity of e-way bill. If you are sending the goods or supplying the goods to your buyer, and the distance from your place of business to the buyer's place, if it is up to 100 kilometer, then validity is 1 day. Here also they have bifurcated over dimensional cargo. For that 20 kilometer limit is there, but other than over dimensional cargo is 100 kilometer per day. And for every 100 kilometer, one more day. Means each 100 kilometer, one day. Suppose your distance from vendor to buyer is 600 kilometer, 610 kilometer, then in all they will get 7 days. Correct? So per 100 kilometer, one day you have to count. This 24 hours, means how to calculate this? Here also they mentioned that, say for example, you have to calculate your limit from the end of the midnight. Suppose aaj 5 baje e-way bill generate ho gaya mera, sham ko 5 baje, to raat ko 12 baje ke baad mera one day limit start hoega. You mind well. Next means 12 bajne ke baad main suppose subah 10 baje bhi generate kiya to bhi raat ko 12 baje ke baad, so in all they will get more hours rather. That is liberal. In this over-dimensional cargo, the limit is 20 kilometers. You must be knowing the big trailer is there. They would define what is what in the Central Motor Vehicle Act. Commissioner may extend a validity period for certain category of goods. Relevant date, I already explained that it would be counted from the midnight. Means 12 baje ke baad it would be counted. suppose I have taken two example. Consider a situation where a consignor is required to move goods from city X to Z. He appoints transporter A for movement of his goods. Transporter A moves the goods from city X to Y. For completing the movement of goods, that is from city Y to Z, transporter A now hand over the goods to transporter B. Here change of transporter is there, and thereafter B will take the goods from city Y to Z. Then how would the EVA bill generated? In this case, EVA bill would be one only from city X to city Z. Only one EVA bill would be generated, and in the initial phase, first transporter A name would be written. Transporter A will write the vehicle number in which he carrying the goods, and when he change over the conveyance, he suppose he gives to another transporter, then he will update new vehicle number and he will carry the goods from city Z Y to Z. Consider a situation where a consignor handovers his goods for transportation on Friday to transporter, but the assigned transporter starts the movement of goods on Monday. How would the validity of EVA bill be calculated in such situation? This happens, practically it happens. आज मैंने ट्रांसपोर्टर को दे दिया, वो दो दिन के बाद वो स्टार्ट किया, तो मैंने तो पार्ट ए भर दिया है, तो क्या करने का इसके अंदर? Yes, unless and until part B vehicle number has been put, validity will not start. This is very important. Otherwise, everybody will stop. Then they will be on the mercy of the transporter. Correct? So when on Monday, when transporter will fill the vehicle number and vehicle type, at from that time your validity starts. The details of EVA bill generated shall be made available to supplier. If it is when suppose I have generated EVA bill, I am the supplier, then my buyer can also view the details of EVA bill. Then he has got an option कि whether to accept or reject. कभी कभी ऐसा होता है, मैंने गलत टिन नंबर डाल दिया कोई दूसरे बायर का विदाउट माय नॉलेज और बाय एरर व्हाट एवर इट मे बी. सो देन द बायर हैज एन ऑप्शन टू सी whether आई हैव टू एक्सेप्ट और रिजेक्ट. इसका मतलब क्या हुआ है कि जब मॉर्निंग में अभी सब लोग व्हाट्सएप और वो देखते हैं, उठ के ब्रश भी बाद में करते हैं, अभी ईवे बिल का पोर्टल देखना पड़ेगा पे मेरे नाम पे कोई जनरेट हुआ है कि नहीं. You will get a message. So here the buyer will have an option to accept or reject. If he wants to accept, no issue, but he wants to reject, then within 72 hours he has to reject that consignment. Registered person may obtain an invoice reference number. This invoice reference number would be helpful while when the goods are in movement, and this invoice number will valid for 30 days. Now certain practical issues. How does, don't look at the answer, I know it is there in my presentation, just try to give. How does taxpayer enters part A details and generate EVA bill when he is transporting goods himself? समझो खुद का टेम्पो में लेके जाता है, खुद की कार में लेके जाता है, तो क्या करने का है? That is must then. अभी उसमें ट्रांसपोर्टर आईडी में क्या करेंगे? व्हीकल नंबर बराबर है, वो तो जो व्हीकल में लेके जाता है वो खुद का GSTPAM नंबर डालना पड़ेगा उसको. Mind well, if you carry the goods on your own in your vehicle, then you have to put your own GSTPAM number so that portal will come to know you are also a transporter carrying the goods. How does the validity of EVA bill starts? I already explained ki when the first entry made in part B. What has to be done if the validity of EVA bill expire? तो क्या करने का? ईवे बिल जनरेट हो गया आपका, अभी वैलिडिटी खत्म हो गया, समझो बियॉन्ड 24 आवर्स हो गया, 24 आवर्स में ही कैंसलेशन का ऑप्शन है, बाद में बाय टू रिजेक्ट व्हाट एल्स. सी इन दिस देयर इज अ ऑप्शन अंडर एक्सेप्शनल नेचर इन ट्रांसशिपमेंट. This provision is there that transporter may extend the validity to apply. Means there is an option available in EWB portal to ask for extension of validity period. And if the reasons are justifiable, it can be extended. That is possible. How to extend the validity period of EWB? See, you have an option to extend the validity period. This option is available for extension of EWA bill before 4 hours and after 4 hours of expiry of validity. Mind well, before 4 hours or after 4 hours from the expiry of validity. And here transporter will have to exercise this option to apply for extension of validity. Is the e-way bill applicable even for movement of goods as a courier? Suppose aap courier se bhejte ho, so whether e-way bill is required? No. Yes, it is required. Even though you are sending the goods through courier, e-way bill is required. You read section rule 138.1. There is a proviso, it empowers a courier agency to generate e-way bill on behalf of the consignor subject to its authorization. So it is required.
So transporter
is carrying 30% at a time, they even credit 35 with bills. Why what would happen to that, you mean to say? I have taken that issue, don't worry. Why am I unable to get GSTPAM transport ID from the Department of Post for filling up Part B of, suppose you are sending the goods through post, why you are not able to get transporter ID? Post ka transporter ID, post ka ID? Yes, post is exempted, that I already explained. They need not have to generate e-way bill. Whether e-way bill is required to be generated for movements of goods from unit of a company to another through own vehicle within 50 kilometers? Yes, I already said it is only benefit is available only for transport.
I have supplied material to courier DDEC Kolkata, but after 7 or 10 days, that DDEC courier has resigned the material to me, stating that we cannot deliver, this is an unserviceable area. Now, what is the remedy? I have already created the invoice, I have already generated the delay.
Your case is of sales return.
No, it's not sales
return. Means there are no recipient. There are no recipient. I have taken that issue. Please. I told you now, majority of the issue which we face in day-to-day practice, I will try to cover. Still anything would be left, I'll take care of that. Whether date of the invoice and date of e-way bill must be the same. Then when should be the date of invoice should be? Prior to, yes, that is very much important.
But it can be same.
It can be same, but before that, before generation of EWA bill. But some clients are very smart enough. EWA bill generate kar dete, baad mein poochte, sir, abhi invoice ka date kya dalu? It happens, huh? I'm telling you. So please take care. Sir, my request is, please let me finish. Please. Is EWA bill required in case same conveyance carries three different invoices, each of them valuing less than 50,000, however total of them exceed 50,000? Yes, I have already explained. If consolidated total value is more than 50,000, it needs to be generated. Is EWA bill required for movement of goods billed as a service, such as wash contract, composite, supplier, job work? Suppose you are purchasing the goods for use in the wash contract, and as we know, this wash contract is created as a service under GST. Whether still EWA bill is required? Yes. Even though your transaction created as a service, but still there is a, when there is a movement of goods, your EWA bill is must. Is EWA bill required for movement of sample costing rupees 50,000 having no commercial value?
Yes,
because there is no differentiation ki sample hai, free hai, kuch nahi. You have to generate EWA bill. Is EWA bill required for movement of warranty replacement parts or repairs valuing more than 50,000? Aap goods ko under warranty mein de rahe ho repair ke liye, still EWA bill. Is EWA bill required for movement of used personal and household effects valuing more than 50,000? No. Why? It was covered under that annexure 138 subsection 14. How the distance has to be calculated if the consignment are imported from or exported to other country? Suppose maine yahan se UK bhej raha hu, to how that kilometer to be counted? Transport? Suppose if it is airline, see, I am locating in say Ghatkopar, and I am sending through Sar cargo, then it means from the place of business to the place from where the goods are actually being exported, and in case of import, from the place where the goods have been reached from other country and clear in customs from that day to place of business. But it practically creates difficulty. In my own case, we face this difficulty. Say for example, Ghatkopar se Sahar kitna kilometer rehta hai, 10, 12 ya 15, correct? So it is very difficult. Suppose we give that goods, my client gives that goods to the courier, फिर वो उसका जो भी procedure करता है, तो it is very difficult for them to start the journey within that validity period. So this is just I would say jugaad. If what has been provided is this only in FAQ, but really we are writing because in 2-3 consignment we face this problem, then he has to apply for extension and all that thing. Now what we are doing, some of the UK we write 4,000 kilometer 5,000 kilometer, there is no issue, still it is going on. Let me tell you, बिकॉज दिस इज प्रैक्टिकल डिफिकल्टी. अगर हम कुरियर वाले को देते हैं तो कुरियर वाले का खुद का भी एक प्रोसेस रहता है, जो भी डॉक्यूमेंट बनाना है, देन दे विल कैरी, और अपना खुद का पार्सल नहीं रहे उसके, दे मस्ट बी हैविंग अनदर कस्टमर, दे विल टेक अलोंग विद ऑल द पार्सल, देन दे विल बुक इन एनी एयरलाइंस, दे कैरी द गुड्स टू एयरपोर्ट. सो इट इज प्रैक्टिकली डिफिकल्ट. जैसा मैंने एग्जाम्पल दिया कि मेरा घाटकोपर से शहर कितना किलोमीटर दूर है, 10-12 किलोमीटर, तो मेरा तो 24 आवर्स का ही वैलिडिटी हुआ. It is very much difficult, and in fact I have inquired with other CHA, they say majority of the persons are writing kilometers, any kilometers, UK US se aap lump sum dal do to matlab validity ka aapko issue nahi aayega, and this is working. Till now we have not faced a problem. But they have provided, yeah, they have provided ki yahi distance aapko count karna hai, but practical difficulty they are not aware, we only knows. whether e-way bill is required if the goods are being purchased and moved by the consumer to his destination himself. Yes, and suppose he don't have the number, consumer ke pas number nahi hai, to there is an option, citizen or something is there. In that he can generate the e-way bill or he can tell the supplier who will generate on his behalf. How to generate e-way bill if the goods of one invoice is being moved in multiple vehicles? समझो यहाँ से मैं मुंबई से समझो कोची जा रहा है, तो यहाँ से समझो by road जा रहा है से airport, airport के बाद में वहां जहां पे समझो कोची उतरेगा, कोची उतरने के बाद समझो वापिस इट गोज बाय कार और एनी अदर मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट और इट इज गोइंग बाय शिप देन एयर, मींस मल्टीपल कन्वीनियंस हैज बीन यूज्ड इन अ पर्टिकुलर ट्रांजेक्शन, देन व्हाट टू डू इन दैट केस, वेदर सेपरेट ईवे बिल नीड्स टू बी जनरेटेड when multiple conveyance, some road, ship, air, again road, whether every time new e-way bill is to be generated? No, only one e-way bill needs to be generated, and every time when there is a change in conveyance, you have to update that. For every, it means that example I have taken, it will come. Wait, very fast it will come, don't worry. How to generate e-way bill for multiple invoices belonging to same consignor and consignee? Then in that case, suppose ek hi din mein I have raised 10 invoices for the same customer at different time in a day only, then whether I can have a combined e-way bill for all the 10 transaction, 10 bills, whether it is permissible? Yes or no?
No.
No. For each of the invoice, you need to generate e-way bill. Agar 10 invoice aapne banaye, to 10 e-way bill needs to be generated. Bhale baad mein for, you can prepare consolidate for transportation, but for each of the bill, you need to generate a separate e-way bill. This way bill 20 kilometers I have already said. What is to be done if the vehicle break down? So kya karne ka? Part B to be updated. Ya to samjho within the validity period if possible he can get the repair his truck and carry the goods in the same vehicle, or if there is a change in the vehicle then updation of part B. What has to be done by the transporter if consignee is refusing to take goods or reject the goods? Suppose आपने EV bill generate कर दिया Mr. X के नाम पे, से यहाँ से आपका गुजरात गया, लेकिन that person either is just one person has asked me, he is not available, traceable, or suppose he is refused to accept that goods, then what is to be done? तो क्या करने का? Yeah. Yes, with the consensus of the supplier, transporter has to generate another e-way bill like sales return or supply return, and he can bring that goods to the supplier. Practically no.
But
in that case, I think at both the place the consigner means main supplier name would be there practically. The transporter cannot be consigner, na? He is just a carrier. He cannot be the consigner. HSN code, I already said that if your turnover is less than 5 crore in previous year, 2 digit, more than 5 crore, 4 digit. Lekin, agar 1 crore tak hai, to for GST return and all that thing, we have been given benefit. You can write description instead of HSN code, but under EWA bill, there is no such provision. So even your turnover is less than 1.5 crore, still HSN code is must. This example I have already taken. Can EWA bill be deleted or cancelled? It can be cancelled, can't be deleted, but cancelled within 24 hours. What is over-dimensional cargo? That 20 kilometer ka limit I already explained. Over-dimensional cargo means a cargo carried as a single indivisible unit and which exceeds the dimensional limit prescribed in Rule 93 of the Central Motor Vehicle Act. In case of B2C transaction, suppose a company hai aur uska jo buyer hai wo say doctor hai, dental implant, take a case, dental supply of dental implants by the company to the doctors and value is more than 50,000. When hand delivery is given by salesman to customer using taxi or local train or bus within Mumbai and Thane, whether EWA bill is required? In that case, EWA bill has to be generated by the company and he has to write vehicle number. Jo bhi hai, taxi number ya in that. Agar personal car hai, to khud ka GSTN number dal ke it can be done. Correct? But there is no way out. But agar public transport hai, then it would be permissible. But still, EWA bill needs to be generated. There is no exception to that. We can't write for public transport. The pin code, though, in a way it would come, no? When you write consignee's detail, the pin code, though, aana hi hai na uske andar. Yeah, in public transport. Public transport. If dealer shows customer came and personally collected product, will that be a solution? Jugaad, yeah. कैसा कंपनी कर सकती है कि कस्टमर मेरे वहां के लेके गया बट देयर ऑल्सो द प्रॉब्लम वुड बी फेस्ड बाय द कस्टमर इफ ही हैज बीन कॉट सो दैट प्रॉब्लम रिमेन्स नहीं यू कैन जस्ट राइट बाय रेलवे यू कैन जस्ट बाय रेलवे एंड इफ इट इज यू आर सेंडिंग द गुड्स थ्रू रेल यू मस्ट बी हैविंग रेल रिसीप्ट नंबर यू Huh? No, I don't think that ticket number would be a rail receipt number. I don't think. You can say by rail. By rail. What is the meaning of consignment value? Yes, can anybody tell me what is the how will you work out your consignment value? That 50,000 jo limit consider karna hai aapko 1 lakh. Taxable value plus tax plus sales jo bhi hai less exempted or non GST or non taxable rather. Even freight amount need not be mentioned in that. It should not be considered for freight charges. In case of movement of goods by railways, is there a requirement to for railway to carry EWA bill along with the goods? For railway need not carry EWA bill, but when you EWA bill needs to be generated, but when you take the delivery, then railway will not give you delivery without EWA bill. Mind well, agar aap railway ke through kuch goods transport kar rahe ho, then in that the railway will not deliver the goods without EWA bill. No, 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 no. expired stock medicine has no commercial value but is often transported back to the seller for statutory and regular requirements or for destruction by the seller himself, what needs to be done for such cases of transportation of expired stock? Whether you need to generate EWA bill?
Yes.
Till now there is no benefit or any option given. How to register on EWA bill portal if transporter is registered in multiple states or union territory on GST portal? Suppose say big transporter is there, they are having multiple offices across the country and they are having various GSTN number. So what is to be done? Because every time they are required to generate EWA bill, for them the benefit facility has been given that they have to fill ENR2. They have to fill for normal transporter ID ENR1, for this getting unique common enrollment number. See, they can register themselves with this unique common enrollment number and all the offices of that transporter across the country can use this unique number. Once they have taken unique number, they cannot use that individual GSTI. Every office of that transporter has to use this unique number. XYZ Limited company has undertaken construction contract from ABC Limited in Maharashtra. As per the terms of the contract, ABC Limited has imported material worth rupees 1 crore and cleared the goods from customs. After clearing the goods, XYZ Limited wants to send the said goods for processing to Messrs. Gauro Enterprise from Mumbai to Pune. The processing charge is rupees 5 lakh. After processing the above goods, Messrs. Gauro Enterprise has to send the said processed goods to the site of the ABC Limited in Mumbai. Now in the aforesaid transaction, how EWA bill provision would be complied? Who will generate EWA bill to whom and what value to be mentioned in EWA bill? What documents are to be accompanied? See, in general, this is live case of my client. Ki, I am a contractor. I have accepted construction work contract from say Messrs. XYZ and based on the contract, I have to import certain item which I have imported, I have cleared in the custom, but this item I cannot use as it is. So I have to get it done some processing. So I have sent that goods to the job worker processor, correct? After processing, I will directly send that processed good to the site of the contractee. So now in this case, who and when and what document and what value to be mentioned? Yeah. First transaction, when you imported, when you clear the goods from custom to job worker's place, that is one transaction. So in that, what document, who will prepare the EWA bill? XYZ, who has accepted the contract, correct? He will generate this EWA bill. He will raise invoice, delivery challan, very good. He will not raise invoice, correct? What value he will write? Yes, value of imported goods. So with this document, it will go to the processor. After process, again, that goods will directly go to the contractee, correct? So then at that time, who will generate EWA bill, what documents are and what value? Job worker or XYZ? Apply your mind. See, the goods are not coming from job worker to XYZ premises. Goods are directly going to the end customer.
XYZ can issue if it is mentioned in the BOB of job worker status is mentioned in the BOB of the.
See, sometimes it may happen. कि मैंने कुछ गुड्स प्रोसेस के लिए दिया है और वहां से मैं डायरेक्ट कस्टमर को भेज देता हूं, तो उसमें जॉब वर्कर विल प्रिपेयर ईवे बिल और यू विल प्रिपेयर ईवे बिल। यस, एक्स वाई जेड विल प्रिपेयर ईवे बिल इन द नेम ऑफ बायर, दैट इज एबीसी लिमिटेड इन दिस केस, करेक्ट। व्हाट वैल्यू टू बी मेंशन? Agreed contract value, I would say. Agreed contract value, which includes my job work charges, my markup, etc., would be there. And here, invoice is to be raised. Delivery challan would not do. Correct? Yahan pe correction aapke answer mein, you just mention I think XYZ Limited only written, no? Then it's correct, no problem. What? Portal? नहीं, why? How? I don't know. It has to be because in bill to ship to क्या करते हैं आप? नहीं, you can write the place delivery from. तो दैट प्रैक्टिकल डिफ आई डोंट हैव सॉल्यूशन फॉर दैट, बट बिल टू शिप टू में आप क्या करते हैं? बिल टू शिप टू में होता है ना,
बिल टू होएगा शिप टू में मैन्युअली टेबल,
बिल टू में प्रिपेयर डिस्पैच फ्रॉम, वहां पे डिस्पैच फ्रॉम ऑप्शन आता है ना, और डिलीवरी फ्रॉम वहां पर आप लिख सकते हो ना, वो थोड़ी बाय डिफॉल्ट आएगा। नहीं नहीं, लेकिन नहीं नहीं करेक्ट, लेकिन उसके अंदर आपको डिस्पैच फ्रॉम आई डोंट थिंक ए प्रीफिल, देर माइट बी पॉसिबिलिटी कि मेरा प्रिंसिपल प्लेस ऑफ बिजनेस समझो मझगांव है, मेरा एडिशनल प्लेस समझो घाटकोपर है, आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर फ्रॉम घाटकोपर एंड इफ यू से इट इज प्रीफिल, आई कैन नॉट राइट घाटकोपर। According to me, it is means you can feed.
We have practically
done it. Still, you can do na? Why not? Anyway, this practical difficulty, according to me, it is possible, but still one can check, because I already said I don't sit on the computer for this e-way bill job. Now, issue relating to bill to ship to for e-way bill under CGST rules. See, bill to ship to, I have given practical example. Ki A is the person who has ordered B to send goods directly to C. B is the person who is sending goods directly to C on behalf of A, and C is the recipient of the goods. मतलब यहाँ पे order किसने दिया है? A ने B को, B को बोला आप C को माल बेचो, correct? The transaction is clear. So यहाँ पे दो invoice बनेगा, एक B to A and second is A to C. दो invoice बन जाएगा. Then who would generate e-way bill for the movement of goods which is taking place from B to C on behalf of A? Either A or B, anybody can generate e-way bill. Both are permissible. Suppose take a case where e-way bill is generated by B, the middle person to whom the original order has been placed. Then what to do? Bill from in this field, details of B are supposed to be filled. Matlab B is the first party. Dispatch from, this is the place from where goods are actually dispatched. It may be the principal or additional place of B. Bill to A and ship to C, correct? Because A is given the order and invoice of one number means B ka invoice. Suppose other way around, suppose A has generated e-way bill, then in that case, bill from in this field, details of A are supposed to be filled. Dispatch from, this is the place from where goods are actually dispatched. Correct? So, yahan pe goods are actually dispatched from B's place. So, A has to write B's address. Bill to ship to mein, dono mein C aayega. Correct? an invoice of 2. See, one very important question I miss, this gentleman asked me part delivery. Let me just take up this.
18, 18. 18,
na? Huh. Suppose you are sending the goods, say in parts, SKD or CKD condition में आप goods move करते हो, तो एक truck में नहीं आते, आपका goods 5 truck में use होता है. So in that case, what is to be done? Suppose there are 5 trucks will be used for complete delivery of the goods. तो पहला step क्या करना है? Before the actually movement starts, first truck के पहले invoice has to be generated. Invoice has to be raised, correct? First step is that, then after delivery chalan, for each of the truck, except last truck, for each of the truck, delivery chalan along with certified copy of invoice to be carried by the vehicle owner or jo bhi hai, matlab, driver, he has to carry that. और लास्ट जो लोड जाएगा आपका, लास्ट गुड्स जो ट्रक में जाएगा, उसके साथ ओरिजिनल इनवॉइस वुड गो. Correct. So you ask the question in part. So this way it is possible. Yeah, EVA bill has to be generated for each transport vehicle. But document would be the delivery challan and lastly invoice. This registration process, it is, I think everybody has done. I need not take much of time. You can do very easily. This EVA bill through API interface means system to system integration. That is possible. Means aapka system or transporter ka system integrate karke with GST portal. It can be done and you can generate EVA bill. Now, interception or inspection of goods. Correct? See, one of the main purpose of EVA bill is to ensure smooth movement of goods at the check post. Let us examine the various process involved in the process of transporting of goods from one place to another. Once the goods are ready for transport, transportation, the transporter has to ensure that two things are in place. First step, kya hai ki if the value is more, value of consignment is more than 50,000, then he should carry a copy of invoice or bill or chalan or bill of entry, etc. and EVA bill in physical form or in soft copy or number. This prime thing he has to carry along with the truck. Suppose person transporter does not carry all these documents, then definitely it's a contravention of provisions of section 129 and 130. Correct? 129 I have taken. 129 speaks about detention of goods. 130 is confiscation of goods. When the goods are in movement, proper officer may intercept or inspect any of the vehicle. They can stop your vehicle, they can check what goods you are carrying, what documents you are carrying. But here there is a cap. Ki suppose ek truck ka already verification ho gaya, suppose yahan se Gujarat ja raha hai aur in between koi place pe wahi vehicle ka inspection ho gaya hai, then another officer again cannot do verification of that truck, that beneficial point they would check. But suppose they are having a doubt or suspects, they are having suspect ke, no, there are some problem with this, there is evasion of tax, then again they can. That is hierarchy, it can be assigned. Yes. Now what is section 129? Section 129 of the CGST Act provide for detention and seizure of the goods and conveyances. Yahan pe dekho, dono power hai. Aapka goods bhi seize ho sakta hai aur aapka vehicle It's a big recurrent problem, and they release on payment of requisite tax and penalty. Suppose in a particular consignment, the goods is accompanied by an invoice or any other specified document, but no EWA bill. Then section 29 will be invocable. अगर आपने डॉक्यूमेंट है लेकिन ईवे बिल जनरेट नहीं हुआ तो सेक्शन 29 वुड बी इनवोकेबल. इट हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड दैट प्रोसीडिंग अंडर सेक्शन 129 ऑफ द सीजीएसटी एक्ट आर बीइंग इनिशिएटेड फॉर एवरी मिस्टेक इन द डॉक्यूमेंट्स एज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड इन रूल 138A. मतलब छोटा से छोटा गलती रहेगा तो भी 129 सेक्शन कैन बी इनवोक. केन provision of section 129 be invoked in case of certain technical error. कुछ नाम में गलती हो गया, spelling में error है, pin code में कुछ error हो गया, या HSN code लिखने का गलती हो गया, तो whether section 129 can be invocable or not. See, it has been clarified in CBIC circular number 64 by 2018. Dated 14 September 2018. What type of error can be ignorable? Spelling mistake in the name of consigner or consignee, but the GSTPAM is correct. Error in the PIN code, but the address of the consigner and consignee mentioned is correct. Subject to that, there should not be a change in very different state rather. Agar PIN code mein chota galti hai, theek hai, address barabar. Lekin agar wo address पिन कोड ऐसा ही लिखा है कि विच इज अफेक्टिंग योर वैलिडिटी पीरियड देन इट वुड नॉट बी परमिसेबल. देन एरर इन एड्रेस ऑफ कंसाइनी टू द एक्सटेंट दैट द लोकेलिटी एंड अदर डिटेल्स आर करेक्ट. एरर इन वन और टू डिजिट ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट नंबर. समझो आपने डॉक्यूमेंट नंबर लिखने में गलती हुआ वन और टू डिजिट, दैट इज परमिसेबल. और HSN कोड में भी समझो आपने गलती किया लेकिन फर्स्ट टू डिजिट करेक्ट है तो भी चलेगा. An error in one or two digit or character of the vehicle number. So all these technical error or clerical error, I would say it is permissible. And for this type of error, they cannot detain your vehicle. But penalty to the tune of rupees 500 each under CGST and SGST or 1000 in IGST would be imposed in form DRC 7. A record of all such consignment where proceeding under section 129 of the CGST Act, जो मैंने अभी example दिया ना different type of errors, or because of that error officer has not taken the action, that record, that detail he need to upload on the portal. He has to report to the higher authority on weekly basis. If a conveyance carrying 10 consignment is intercepted and for and only for two consignment the person in charge fails to produce EWA bill or other relevant document, then whether detention can be made of all consignment or only two such consignment or conveyance? Only two or pura? For only two. Rest he can, he should release. Correct? Jo consignment ka document nahi hai ya EWA bill nahi hai, that will be detained. No. Now, what procedure to be followed by the proper officer? Where the समझो उसने एक गाड़ी को stop किया उसने, then first step is the officer has to take statement. जो भी लोरी के अंदर है समझो driver है ट्रक के अंदर ड्राइवर है तो उसका एक स्टेटमेंट लेता है. दैट इज इन फॉर्म नंबर जीएसटी एमओवी 01. दिस इज मस्ट फर्स्ट थिंग. उसको एमओवी 01 में स्टेटमेंट लेना है. उसके बाद में ही शैल इश्यू अ फिजिकल ऑर्डर. ऑफिसर हैज टू इश्यू अ फिजिकल ऑर्डर इन एमओवी 02 एंड ही शुड हैंड इट ओवर दैट ऑर्डर टू द कंसर्न पर्सन. वेदर रजिस्टर्ड डीलर रहेगा तो उसको, नहीं तो लोरी के साथ जो है उसको ऑर्डर. वो व्हाट इज मेंशन मींस इन दैट ऑर्डर व्हाट इज मेंशन दैट द he will stop that vehicle at particular place. If you refer that form, I will not go into that deep, MOV 012, but in that order they will write that you he will stop your vehicle, and that vehicle has to be kept at particular place for inspection of goods. And within 24 hours from the issuance of MOV 02, he has to prepare a report in part A of EWB 03, and he has to upload the same on common portal. See, one good thing in GST is what? No doubt majority of the compliance only dealer has to do, but some restriction they have put on the officer also. They will also be cannot be live as it is. Matlab they have put certain ke bhai itna time mein to karna hi, otherwise he may come under the fold. So in this case, ki once he issue the order of inspection in MOV 02, he has to upload his report within 24 hours on the portal, and final report he has to upload in 3 days. Final report he has to upload on the portal in 3 days. Suppose if it is practically not possible, or suppose circumstances warrant that it needs more time for inspection, then he has to take written permission of from his higher authority in MOV 3. And after completion of physical verification, he has to prepare a report of such physical verification in MOV 04, and show the copy to the concerned person. Suppose after verification there are no discrepancy found, everything is in order, then he has to issue MOV 05. It's nothing but a release order, and because of that release order the goods can be moved further. Suppose officer is of the view, okay, no, this is still some problem is there, he wants to detain these goods or this vehicle, then he has to issue an order in form number MOV 06, and against that he has to issue notice to the concerned person in MOV 07 that I am going to detain your vehicle and goods unless and until you make the payment. Suppose when the vehicle has been intercepted and detained for a period exceeding 30 minutes, the transporter may upload the same information in EWB 04. Practically I am not aware whether this facility is in it is in use or not, because earlier it was not there. As on today I am not aware whether as on today any transporter can upload, because this is a good thing ki aadha ghante se zyada rukaya to immediately he will put this information on the portal, then department would come to know, so that unnecessary harassment would go away. Consequences for not generating and not carrying an EWA bill for the consignment value exceeding ₹50,000. What are the consequences? Section 122 subsection 1, where a taxable persons who issue any invoice or bill without supply of goods or services or both in violation of the provision of this act and rules, or transport any goods, taxable goods, without the core of document, then he shall be liable to pay penalty of ₹10,000 or an amount equivalent to the tax evaded, whichever is higher. So either 10,000 or the tax amount which is higher would be the penalty. Plus suppose aapka goods inspect hua hai and the supporting documents are not there, there are two options available. Suppose owner comes on their own, ki bhai owner admit kar deta hai, nahi bhai hamara galti hai, I am ready to pay the tax. So in that case, if it is taxable goods, then the penalty would be tax plus 100% of the tax amount, so basic tax plus equal to that. If it is for exempted goods, then 2% of the value of the goods, or ₹25,000, whichever is lower. But suppose owner does not come on his own, Then for taxable goods, penalty would be tax plus 50% of the value of the goods. And for exempted goods, 5% of the value of the goods or 25,000, whichever is lower. So these are the penalty applicable under section 129. So once the whether owner comes forward or don't come forward, but after making payment only, the GST MOV 5 release order would be issued. And once all this procedure is completed, then final order would be uploaded by the officer in GST MOV 09. And once the upload MOV 09, it will debit your electronic liability ledger. And when you make the payment, here one important thing is what? Suppose they raise the demand of 1 lakh rupees, but either you have two options. Suppose you accept, so 1 lakh either you can make cash payment or it can be adjusted against your ITC. That option is available to you. It's not necessary that you have to make cash payment, but for that you have to file DRC 03. Here another option is also available. Suppose aapke paas ITC nahi hai, aapko cash payment nahi karna hai, you can submit bank guarantee. That is also permissible in MOV 08. So if the dealer is submitted bank guarantee, then also they can release the good. There are so many judgments are there on this bank guarantee. While this proceeding, if any objection have been raised by the dealer or the transporter, then officer has to take into consideration the objection raised by him, is to take a note, and then only final order would be passed. Suppose he has passed the order in 09, and if the tax has not been paid within 7 days, then he has to issue detention. In case proposed tax and penalty are not paid within 7 days from the date of issue of order of detention in MOV 06, action under section 130 would be taken by serving a notice in MOV 0, MOV 10. So in that case, suppose 130 when they will invoke, then they can confiscate your goods and convenience both. Suppose officer ko doubt hi hai ki nahi ye goods it is moving because of evasion of tax. So at first stage only they can apply, they can invoke section 130. That is also permissible. But no such order can be passed without affording an opportunity of hearing. That is must. An order of confiscation of goods or the conveyance will be passed in MOV 11. Once the confiscation of the goods order has been passed, then the property of such goods or conveyance will be transferred in favor of central government. और उसके लिए भी दे आर गिविंग 3 months. अगर 3 months में भी उन्होंने पेमेंट नहीं किया, देन दे विल ऑक्शन दैट गुड्स और प्रॉपर्टी. वंस द ऑर्डर हैज बीन पास्ड बाय से सीजीएसटी अथॉरिटी, द सिमिलर ऑर्डर आर आल्सो हैज टू बी पास्ड बाय लोकल, दैट इज स्टेट अथॉरिटी or Union Territory Authority. Suppose जो consignment जिसका पकड़ा है convenience, वो unregistered dealer है, उसके पास number ही नहीं है. जिसका number है वो तो easily can be process can be done. तो उसके लिए temporary ID would be created for unregistered. The rest provisions are same, but for unregistered dealer, temporary ID will be created. And same provision would be applicable to IGST also. Now, what is the procedure on the part of the dealer? डीलर को क्या करना है कि वंस समझो ऑफिसर इज फाउंड आउट कि जिसमें टैक्स इज नॉट पेड और इट इज मींस पार्टली पेड देन दे विल फर्निश दिस डिटेल ऑन द पोर्टल इन डीआरसी वन एंड डीआरसी टू. Now, dealer has two choice. One, he can make cash payment or check payment and submit the challan and DRC3. Or in DRC3 itself, he can write that adjust this liability against my input tax credit. This is permissible. Or else, appeal is always there. If he don't want to accept, he can go for appeal. Suppose dealer ने payment कर दिया है, whatever amount has been liability has been raised, then the proper officer has to issue the order in DRC 05, concluding the proceeding. Whether here now 5 to 6 high court judgment I will consider whether goods can be detained if EVA bill been generated after movement of goods but before interception of the same by department. Goods move ho gaya, EVA bill generate nahi hua hai. Lekin the before the proper officer has intercepted that vehicle or that consignment, he has generated EVA bill. So whether it would be permissible? Yes, there is a high court judgment. Messrs. Bhumika Enterprise versus State of UP. Whether seizure of goods for mere non-mentioning of vehicle number in Part B of EVA bill while moving the goods from dealer's place for business to transporter place is illegal. See, ये judgment में that 50 kilometer was helpful in this particular judgment. That since the it was less than 50 kilometers, so it was permissible. VSL alloys. Whether department was justified in levying penalty equal to the value of goods transported without complete EVA bill. Ye gati transport ka judgment hai. Seeing that you just read the court's observation. The petitioner is a national level courier company and engages employees who are expert in uploading EVA bill. Filling Part B in EVA bill is mandatory requirement and cannot be treated as a technical error. The explanation of the petitioner that Part B could not be updated due to technical error could not be accepted since the petitioner had not raised any grievance on this issue either online or in writing. Minor penalties could be levied only in cases where the tax was approved is 5,000. See, these are the court observation. So, yahan pe ek one important point kya hai ki samjho, aapko koi ye process mein koi technical glitches aayi hai. So, first and foremost thing is you put a grievance. It will help you in future course of action when you go in appeal or further level. Agar aapne grievance dala hai, because in various judgment I read, wherever the dealer has put the grievance that because of this problem, I am unable to feed this or complete this process, it was in helpful to them. Safe side. This is required. Ye gati, isko to mere kaise 1.5 crore ya jyada liability lagaya tha gati ko to. Whether goods can be seized on the sole ground of absence of EVA bill. Yahan pe, since bank guarantee was furnished, so the goods were released. It was Anuj General Store and two others. This is very interesting case. The residents of Trivandrum, Kerala, had purchased a car from a company situated in Pondicherry. An entrusted car to the company for its transportation to Trivandrum, which was intercepted by the competent authority of Kerala and treated as interstate transaction, whether justifiable in law. Ye transaction mein kya hai? कि केरला का रेसिडेंट है, उसने कार बुक किया है पोंडिचेरी से, करेक्ट, वहां पे पेमेंट भी कर दिया, और वो जो कार सेलिंग कंपनी है उनको बोला है कि यू डिलीवर दिस गुड्स टू माय प्लेस केरला, करेक्ट. तो ड्यूरिंग दैट गुड्स इन ट्रांजिट इट वॉज caught or it was intercepted, so officer was saying ke it's a interstate transaction and levy of tax and penalty would be there. There was no e-way bill generated in this. But in this, the argument on the dealer side was, since the car was for my personal purpose, it was not in the course of business, and my transaction gets completed when I book the car and make the payment. तो माय ट्रांजेक्शन गेट्स कंप्लीटेड इन पोंडिचेरी इटसेल्फ, बाद में वहां से मूवमेंट हुआ, तो इट वाज अ इंटरस्टेट ट्रांजेक्शन एंड नॉट अ इंटरस्टेट ट्रांजेक्शन, एंड देयर वाज अ कोर्ट हैज गिवन द जजमेंट इन फेवर ऑफ द डीलर, कून मोटर कंपनी प्राइवेट लिमिटेड, केरला हाईकोर्ट. आई थिंक इसमें आपका आंसर यस लिखा है ना, यू मेक इट नो. In case of interception of goods and acceptance by the seller by making payment of tax and penalty, whether input tax credit be available for the said tax paid, whether to reflect in GST or one, this is very common problem and big problem. Say for example, I have supplied the goods from Mumbai, Maharashtra to Gujarat. I have raised the bill 1 lakh plus 18,000 CGST or IGST. Correct? मैंने bill raise कर दिया, EV bill नहीं generate किया. मेरा गुड सीज हो गया, करेक्ट, कन्फिस्केट हो गया, जो भी है 129 या 130 में एक्शन हो गया. देन आई हैव मेड द पेमेंट ऑफ टैक्स पेनल्टी, जो भी है, वेदर माय बायर वुड बी एंटाइटल टू गेट आईटीसी और नॉट. व्हाई? टैक्स का क्रेडिट, पेनल्टी जाने दो, मिलेगा. इफ आई वुड से नो, 17(5), यू रीड 17(5), सेक्शन 17 सबसेक्शन 5, इट स्पेसिफिकली रिस्ट्रिक्ट गुड्स कन्फिस्केटेड, या दे हैव रेफर्ड सेक्शन 74, 129, 130, यू आर बार. तो इसमें प्रॉब्लम होएगा, जिसको आपने माल बेचा है वो 1,18,000 नहीं, वो 1,00,000 ही देगा. वो बोलेगा व्हाई शुड आई पे, आई वुड नॉट पे टैक्स अमाउंट बिकॉज आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू गेट आईटीसी फॉर दैट. सो इट्स अ लॉस. हाँ, नहीं, एक लाइव केस ही अभी आया था मेरे पास, तो जो बायर है उसने मना कर दिया, आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू रिमबर्स यू टैक्स अमाउंट बिकॉज आई एम नॉट एंटाइटल्ड फॉर आईटीसी. Still. Section 17, subsection 5. And last, suppose Messrs. ABC of Maharashtra has issued invoice to Messrs. XYZ of Delhi, but not generated e-way bill. The goods have... iske earlier question mein, whether it is to be reflected in GSTR 1? Mera goods confiscated hua, maine tax bhar diya. तो मुझे वो ट्रांजेक्शन वन में दिखा, जस्ट सोचो, इट्स नॉट सो इजी टू गिव यस आंसर, बी प्रैक्टिकल. कि अगर आप जीएसटीआर वन में समझो अमाउंट लिखा, तो देन यू हैव टू राइट टैक्स अमाउंट भी लिखना पड़ेगा, तो इट विल क्रिएट प्रॉब्लम. कल उठ के डिपार्टमेंट बोलेगा ये टैक्स भरो, कहां भरा है, डबल टैक्स. सो इट्स अ प्रैक्टिकल, मीन्स आई डोंट नो, आई डोंट हैव द सॉल्यूशन, बट इट्स अ प्रैक्टिकल. अकॉर्डिंग टू मी वी नीड नॉट सो देन जीएसटीआर वन में. But anyway, one need to check this. And last, suppose Messrs. ABC of Maharashtra has issued invoice to XYZ of Delhi, but not generated e-way bill. The goods have been intercepted in Gujarat. Gujarat authority, this is also a practical problem facing by so many dealers, ki Maharashtra se Delhi ja raha hai, Gujarat mein goods intercept hua. Gujarat wala kya bolta hai? They are not levying IGST. Wo bolta hai, wahan ka CGST, SGST par. So whether it is justifiable, ये एकदम practical problem है, and as on today there is no solution, it is happening. So friends, I have tried to cover my portion, whatever has been allotted to me. Before conclude, I once again thank all the six association, including GSTPAM, for giving me an opportunity to share my views. And lastly, I thank you all for making this session interactive and patient hearing. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Really, thanks. Bye bye.